Hello viewers, welcome back to my channel. So let's start today's topic. Today also we are discussing multiplication series. Okay, so today also we are discussing like earlier video, it's a multiplying by series of nines, but this is a different method compared to our earlier method. So in this method we have one condition. So the condition is the number of digits at left hand side must be equal to the number of nines at right hand side. Okay, so one more time I'm repeating. So now the number of digits at left hand side should be equal to the number of nines at right hand side. Okay, so if our examples satisfy this condition, then we can apply this method. So this method is even more easier than our earlier method. Okay, so let's see how to do this kind of questions when the both side the number of digits are same. Okay, so let's take a few examples, then you will understand what I'm saying. So let me start with the simple examples. So the first one is 323 times. So if you have three digits in first number, so we should have the same three numbers in the second number. So yeah, when we multiply, so whatever the number we have, we need to write down as it is except the ones place. Ones place we need to decrement by one. Okay, so I'll change the pen so that you will understand clearly. 3 2 3 minus 1 is 2. So 3 2 2, and then after that, after writing this number, we need to find out the nines complement of this number, or I can say r minus 1's complement. Okay, so how to get that value? So whenever I add this number and this number, so you should get 9, 3 plus 6 which is 9. Again 2 plus how much you will add to get 9, 7. So again 2, 7. So that's our answer. Is that simple? Isn't it? Yeah, it's so simple. So the answer is 322,677. Okay, so let's take some more bigger numbers. So yeah, method is very simple. Just till ones place you need to write down all the values as it is. After that you will decrement by one, and then you will complement the answer. Okay, so other part is we need to complement the answer. Okay, so let's consider one more example. 4267. I took little bit bigger number than earlier, 9999. So 4 2 6, and then 7 minus 1 which is again 6. Okay, and then we need to do complement to this number. So 4 plus 5, 9, then 2 plus 7, 9, and 6 plus 3, 9. That's our answer. Very simple, right? So let's do one more question. So now I will take bigger than this. My next number, five three two six seven times 999. So I should have three digits, 99999. So the answer is 5326, and then decrement this value by one, so which is again 6. Okay, then we need to add the complements. 5 plus 4, 6 plus 3, 1's place we need to write on as it is, and in 1's place we will decrement by 1, then we should write complement. Okay, so that is 5 plus 4. I will try to change the I'm trying to change the pen. Yes, 5 plus 4, 9, 3 plus 6, and then 2 plus 7, then 6 plus 3, then again 6 plus 3. So that's our answer. So see here, even for the bigger numbers, we are easily able to write the answer. Okay, so let's do our next question. So where is it? Let's do our next question. Five, five, four, two, six, seven. Time, so how many digits are there? Six. So write down 6, 9. Now let's do, write down the answer. 5, 5, 4, 2, 6, 6. Just we need to decrement one value. So I want to change the color. Okay, done. Next, just add the complement values. 4, 4, 5, 7, 3, 3. So that's our answer. So just hardly it will take 5 to 10 seconds. So easy. Let's do our next question. Three, two, three. Yeah, now I'm taking like a different kind of problem. So if we have like different digits, so how to do? Can we apply this method? Yes, of course. So just we need to append the zero in front of a number. Okay, of course, we can do this only for if the multiplicand doesn't contain the equal number of digits. So just append zero to that. Okay, then remaining part is as it is. So 0, 3, 2, 2, because 3 minus 1. And then I do the complement to whole number 9, 6, 7, and then 7. Okay, so that's our answer. Even though if the digit doesn't match, so we can try using this way. So let's do one more question. So I'll try to consider one more big questions. One big question related to this method means how we can convert a non-equivalent values to equivalent. I mean non-equivalent digits to equivalent digits. So 2, 3, 6, 4 times 9, 9, 9. So now I have 5 nines, so I should have 5 digits in multiplicand. So that's why I'm adding one more zero. Then let's do it. 0, 2, 3, 6, 4 minus 1, 3. Okay, and then we need to add 9, 7, 6, 3, and then 6. So that's how, even though the digits are not same, so we can try to convert. So that's it for today's class. I hope you got all the concepts. Thanks for watching. See you in the next video. Bye bye. Don't forget, age is just number. Happy learning.